vidas.
She conceived by the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it done to me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
and the Word was made flesh
and dwelt amongst us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Therefore, as we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
Yon Tiveros. Welcome to Newsnight, where we go above and beyond the headlines. Tonight on the program, India wins the coveted Miss Universe crown, while the country's bet, Beatriz Luigi Gomez, stuns with a top five finish. The foreign affairs chief claims the country dropped the ball on another deal, this time for syringes. But for the health secretary, this is, quote, absolutely false. And the Commission on Elections wants to act fast on moves to cancel Bongbong Marcos's presidential bid by blocking similar petitions that it says will only delay the case. Now, before we go to our top story, we have this breaking news. A magnitude 5.3 earthquake hit Batangas at 5:12 this afternoon. FEVOLC says the epicenter was located 24 kilometers west of Calatagan town. Intensity 2 felt in San Felipe in Zambales, while instrumental intensity 1 recorded in Quezon City, Tagaytay, and Batangas. FEVOLC says aftershocks are expected. This is a developing story. We'll bring you more details as soon as they become available. Now, shifting gears now, after a 21-year drought, India finally brings home another Miss Universe crown. Harnaz Sandhu bested 79 other candidates to win the pageant's 70th edition in Israel, succeeding Mexico's Andrea Meza. This is India's third title. The first was Sushmita Sen in 1994, who was crowned here in Manila. The 21-year-old Sandhu urged young people to know they are unique and to stop comparing themselves to others. Paraguay and South Africa were the first and second runners-up, respectively. Philippine bet Beatriz Luigi Gomez ended her run with a top-five finish. The 26-year-old Cebuana beauty aced the swimsuit and evening gown competitions, but bowed out after the question-and-answer portion for the top-five candidates. While Gomez was earlier criticized for being quiet, a pageant expert said this worked to her advantage, calling her a breath of fresh air among other contestants.
All her rivals in the competition, they were already giving their best during the preliminary competition. But Bea, true to her form, still stuck to her strategy of being a low profile. and a silent killer in the competition, making it to top five, beating all the other 75 contestants to be where she was earlier. That really says a lot about her character, her quiet confidence to make it happen.
Former queens also full of praises for Bea Gomez on social media. Miss Universe 2018 Capriona Gray and last year's Bet Rabia Mateo shared on Twitter that Gomez made the country proud. Miss Universe Philippines 2014 MJ Lastimosa says, quote, "What a finish," hailing Gomez for bringing the country back to the top five after 3 years. Miss Universe 2015 Pia Wurtzbach says that while expectations are being raised every year, finishing the top five is already a feat and that Gomez's victory should also be celebrated. Another Filipino also making the country proud, this time for his winning creation. Miss Nigeria bagged the Best National Costume Award, a head-turning three-foot tribal mask with an ancient cape put together by fashion designer Kennedy John Gaspar. This was inspired by the traditional masquerade of a Nigerian tribe. Gaspar also designed Miss Cameroon's costume in last year's pageant. Health Secretary Francisco Duque refutes claims that the country again dropped the ball, this time on an offer of 15 million syringes for COVID-19 vaccines. Duque made the statement after Foreign Affairs Chief Teodoro Loxin revealed yet another, quote, missed opportunity to obtain syringes for vaccination. The Health Secretary says there is no basis for the claims. The DOH purchased 100 million pieces of syringes worth 2 pesos and 38 centavos, or 4.8 U.S. cents each. Loxin said such a deal was, quote, hallucinatory, and that no one on the planet makes Pfizer syringes that cheap, unquote. Duque slams the DFA chief, saying it would be unlawful to raise the approved budget contract.
Why will I allow the DOH to agree to a higher approved budget contract? That is in violation of RA 9184 and a potential case of anti-graft can be filed if we will allow ourselves to be influenced by suppliers. And we cannot do that. It is not in our ethos. It's not in the DOH manner of procuring. Okay, we abide by the provisions of RA 9184. So, sorry, but there is no such a thing as dropping of the ball. He probably dropped the ball, but not the DOH.
Vaccine czar Carlito Galvez also denies Loxin's allegations. Galvez says the only issue was the supply of syringes for Pfizer shots, but these are being taken care of by the UNICEF. The United States also reached out to help. Amid issues hounding the purchase of syringes for vaccination, the government is gearing up for another round of the nationwide inoculation program. Vaccine czar Carlito Galvez says they hope to vaccinate up to 9 million Filipinos. That was the same target in the first wave, but the government fell short, delivering only over 8 million doses. Galvez says the country now has 62 million COVID-19 shots and is expecting the arrival of 50 million more. Chrissy Di Matulak reports.
Gloria Lorenciano is a street sweeper from Cavite. She has hypertension. She says her job demands vaccination for workers.
Kailangan na namin sa trabaho. Di ho kami mapasama sa renewal pag hindi kami nakapag-vaccine.
Gloria will benefit from the second national vaccine drive on December 15 to 17. She will receive her second dose. The initial vaccination drive on November 29 to December 1 resulted in more than 7 million people getting the shot. National Task Force Against COVID-19 Deputy Chief Implementer Vince Dizon is confident the second round can surpass this number.
So ngayon, ang binigay na target ni Secretary Duque ay 7 million for the 3 days. Pero kami ni Secretary, tingin namin, kaya yan between 7 to 9 million.
The World Health Organization recently flagged the country's nationwide vaccination drive. Its officials say the government should prioritize the unvaccinated among the vulnerable group. The government says there is enough supply for everyone.
Unang-una, priority talaga natin yung seniors and immunocompromised. Yun talaga ang priority. Pero since we have enough supply, sabay-sabay na tayo.
Vaccine Czar Carlito Galvez says the country is close to reaching herd immunity as a little over half of the 100 million population has been vaccinated. Vaccinating 70% of the population is now easy, especially with a steady supply of vaccines. Chrissy De Matulak, CNN Philippines.
In the United States, the search for survivors continues after 50 tornadoes hammered 8 states last week. Over 100 people are feared dead. At least 80 are in western Kentucky, one of the hardest hit areas. Officials expect that number to rise. Over 300 National Guard troops are conducting search and rescue efforts. Philippine Ambassador to the U.S., Babe Romualde, says they have not received reports of affected Filipinos, but asks communities to monitor local advisories. Up next, lawmakers were looking into the alleged smuggling of agricultural products. We have an exclusive report from our senior correspondent, Lois Calderon. And the Commission on Elections blocks related moves seeking to cancel Bongbong Marcos's presidential bid. Details right after the break.
Merry Christmas ang bati, lahat tayo ay magdiwang.
Ang Pasko may panahon sa pagmaya o paghatag o kalipay sa atong mga mahal sa kinabuhi o sa atong isip katao. Kini ang inyong alagad sa dakbayan sa dapitan, si Bimbim Amoy ng Hinao. Naunta luyo ng atong kahintang karon. Naunta ana kita sa luwas sa atong panglawas. Aron sa mabulukong pagsaulog sa pagkatao ng atong manunubos nga si Jesus. Maayong Pasko o masanagong bagong tuig kaninyong tanan. Daghang salamat.
Quincentenary Faith Rewind.
The image of Santo Niño was among the gifts presented to Queen Juana, wife of Fra Humabon, before her baptism. The cross and the image of the Blessed Mother were the other gifts given to her, according to Antonio P. Gaffetta.
KBP marks 500 years of Christianity at this station.
DXTD, Dipolo Radio Ronda.
Ang tatay ko, sinagot ang ospital at papagamot ko.
Sino yung tatay ko?
Yung tatay ko?
Yung tatay ko?
Ah, ang tatay ko?
Si Tatay Digong?
Si Tatay Digong?
Si Tatay Digong?
Si Tatay Digong?
Siya ang tatay ko.
Mabuhay ang malayang Pilipinas.
Bawat patak, may sarap, may lakas, sulit. Red Horse Beer.
Kidimiti sarap ng Pure Foods ready-to-eat spaghetti. Easy to prepare, even for kids. Ngayong Pasko, kasama ang sarap ng pamilya.
We are a direct selling company and our vision is sharing prosperity globally through entrepreneurship. We have done great sharing prosperity in the Philippines. We have conquered the pandemic. Every year we have grown our business and we're excited to venture, you know, outside of the Philippines starting next year. When the first lockdown was announced, we were affected also. We have a lot of people, you know, dependent on us, on the business that they have in IFERN, and we needed to find a way to conquer. We needed to shift what we were doing offline, online. So we were able to continue. The creature that will survive is not the strongest, it's the most adaptable. And we were able to adapt as a company.
The winner in the vitamins and supplements category is Fern D.
We're so happy, no, to receive our third World Branding Award in a row. We're fortunate, no, that our world-class vitamin D, Fern D, is being promoted by World Health Organization. During the awarding, no, we're fortunate to know that we're the only vitamins that was awarded.
iFern Corporation from the Philippines, congratulations to all.
Maraming kumpanya nahirapan, no? They had difficulty during the pandemic, and there are companies that were able to inspire. And we're fortunate that our growth now has been recognized, and we are the only awardee for growth from the Philippines. My big crazy dream, no, is for iFern to be the first globally known Filipino brand. That's the company that grows successful entrepreneurs. My hope is for other entrepreneurs to be inspired by what we have done. Kung kaya namin gawin, kaya nyo rin. If an ordinary Filipino company like iFern can do it, you can do it also. Small investment, unlimited returns. That's what we promise. And all of our products are world-class and affordable. And according to my AIM professor, that's a deadly combination. And that's why we were able to beat the pandemic.
Sa 2021!
Sa Hyper tayo
yayaman!
Welcome back to CNN. Philippines authorities are getting to the bottom of yet another online fraud, this time involving one of the country's biggest banks. BDO Unibank guarantees that clients will get back what they lost. And as Stanley Gaheta reports, police are encouraging more victims to come forward and for the public to be more cautious about transactions.
22-year-old Shasta could not believe losing in one go tens of thousands of pesos from her account as a result of an online scam. She was among BDO depositors hacked by an unknown Mark Nagoyo and losing 50,000 pesos that were transferred to Union Bank.
Pagka-check ko sa personal email ko, stated talaga doon 50,000 and then pumunta doon sa account of Mark Nagoyo. Tapos nakalagay pa doon sa purpose ng transaction, donation.
Messages are circulating that Mark Nagoyo, with the registered Viber number, is from the South.
The PNP Anti-Cybercrime Group has recorded a total of 382 similar cases and complaints on mobile banking scam and online fraud this year. However, this figure is too small compared to numerous incidents happening in the cyber world.
The police say they are cracking down on online fraud, but the process takes time.
Sa bank secrecy at saka sa Data Privacy Act, hindi mo pwedeng i-disclose ang mga information. Kaya nga tayo nag-a-apply ng warrant to disclose computer data para magkaroon. It doesn't happen overnight. Minsan it takes like from 2 weeks to roughly 30 days.
Still, the police anti-cybercrime group says victims should file complaints.
They have to come to us para matulungan natin sila.
The National Bureau of Investigation says it is coordinating with BDO and Union Bank on the issue and looking at possible security loopholes.
Baka na-exploit yung ng mga hackers yung isang gap or vulnerability ng system, kaya sila nakapag-transfer ng funds. Although may sophistication talaga. Kasi all of a sudden, ang daming na-transfer.
Cybersecurity expert J.J. Decine explains the bank clients were victims of a fraud called phishing.
Nakalitan yung control doon sa account at napunta ngayon doon sa hacker. Hindi pa natin masasabi na may parang long-term solution for security, maybe in the future.
In a statement, Union Bank says it is determining the amount involved in the scam while coordinating with the Anti-Money Laundering Council and the Banco Central ng Pilipinas on the issue. BDO, meanwhile, said additional security is in place to protect their clients. The bank added it will reimburse its clients. Despite the incident, the NBI says people should still trust online transactions.
Kapag ka-umpisan natin, hindi na tayo mag-online transaction, panalo na yung mga hackers na yan dahil hindi lang tayo nanakawan, natakot pa tayo.
For now, Shasta says she is filing a complaint and is hoping to recover her hard-earned money soon. Stanley Gaheta, CNN Philippines.
A look now at what some presidential aspirants are up to. Senator Ping Lacson welcomes the Commission on Elections mandate requiring 2022 candidates to have their YouTube accounts verified. Lacson says the move is a much-needed step against disinformation on social media. Vice President Lenny Robredo appeals to COMELEC to expand absentee voting to cover employees from the business process outsourcing sector. IT BPO representatives in Cebu told Robredo they hope to have a 24-hour polling place because of their work shifts. Manila Mayor Isko Moreno calls on the Banco Central to reconsider its new design for the 1,000 peso bill. Moreno questions why the BSP decided to replace the images of World War II heroes with that of the Philippine Eagle. The current 1,000 peso bill features Jose Abad Santos, Vicente Lim, and Josefa Lianis Escoda, who all resisted Japanese occupation in the Philippines.
while it is true that Eagle should be there also, but siguro pwede naman halfway yun. Pwede naman sa kabila, nandun pa rin yung ating mga heroes, tapos yung ating national treasure. I would rather have our heroes to be there. Siguro it's high time for us to create Department of National History and Culture.
The COMEC denies all interventions linked to the first of multiple petitions against Bongbong Marcos's presidential bid. The COMEC Second Division rejected one anti-Marcos intervention filed by the group of attorney Howard Calleja, as well as two pro-Marcos responses filed by the Partido Federal ng Pilipinas and the group of the presidential aspiring spokesman, lawyer Vic Rodriguez. All three wanted to weigh in on the petition from the group of lawyer Theodore Te, which seeks to cancel Marcos's certificate of candidacy because of his 1995 tax conviction. COMEC says allowing these interventions would unduly delay the resolution of the main petition. The poll body will no longer entertain similar submissions in the future. Marcos currently faces four disqualification cases, two petitions to cancel his COC, and one to declare him a nuisance candidate for the 2022 polls. We'll take a quick break, and when we come back, college athletes can step back into the court for practice and prepare for the much-awaited return of the UAAP Games. And for those who are still looking for Christmas presents, we give you an update on the holiday shopping rush in Divisoria. Keep it here on CNN Philippines.
Centenary Faith Rewind.
Ferdinand Magellan died in the hands of Dato Lapu-Lapu in the Battle of Mactan. Spanish navigator Juan Sebastian Elcano took command of the voyage, which finally reached the Spice Islands. Today, the expedition is also known as Magellan-Elcano Expedition.
KBP marks 500 years of Christianity at this station.
Honorable Angel Halusos Carion, Batanon, Buutan ug Malagaron, City Councilor of the Pitan City, Chairman, Committee on Tourism, Committee on Labor, Committee on Child Welfare and Development. Honorable Angel Halusos Carion, Batanon, Buutan ug Malagaron, City Councilor of the Pitan City.
DXTD, Dipolo, Radyo, Ronda.
Love is all about time. Madali ang pagpapasarap. Like the love in every Pure Foods ready to eat. Slow cooked and ready in 8 minutes. Para may time ka sa mga mahal mo. Because love takes time.
Sa pagbangon ng mga Pilipino, saludo ako sa mga taong patuloy na humaharap sa hamon ng pagbabago.
Bilang isang ina, handa akong gawin ang lahat para sa kaligtasan ng aking mga anak.
Pandemya man, tuloy pa rin ang serbisyo para malinis ang kapaligiran.
Servisyong publiko para sa kaligtasan ng lahat.
Sa panahon ng krisis, ikaw, ako, magtulungan tayo. Saludo ako sa Pilipino.
May pagbabago man sa dekorasyon, sa pangangaruling, at sa simoy ng selebrasyon, ang maiiwan na damang-dama ay sarap ng Pasko na buong-buo.
Sa Pasko, Pure Foods.
Sarap na hatid ng Pure Foods Noche Buena.
Sa Pasko, Pure Foods.
Sarap na dala ng pamilyang bumubuo sa Pasko.
Sa Pasko,
buo ang Pasko sa Pasko, Pure Foods.
Ang tatay ko, ginawang ligtas, panatag at maayos ang buong bayan.
Wala yan sa tatay ko. Ibinalik ang ganda ng Boracay.
Mas magaling yung tatay ko. Nakamit niya ang kapayapaan sa Mindanao.
Ang tatay ko, sinagot ang ospital at pagpagamot ko.
Sino yung tatay ko?
Ang tatay ko.
Tatay ko.
Ang tatay ko.
Si Tatay Digong.
Si Tatay Digong.
Si Tatay Digong.
Si Tatay Digong.
Siya ang tatay ko.
Taas noon nating pagmalaki, tayo ay Pilipino.
Sang-ayon ba ang lahat na ang best tasting chicken dog ay TJ din? Walang duda na ang tender, ang juicy, best tasting chicken hotdog talaga. Chicken ang desisyon! Kids can tell, best tasting ang TJ chicken dog!
Boracay has put the country on the map for domestic and international tourism. It is only fitting that the gateway to this paradise island is modern and state-of-the-art. SMC Infrastructure has taken the lead in overseeing the improvements of the Boracay Airport. Throughout the years, it carried several name changes, from Katiklan Airport to Godofredo P. Ramos Airport, but it lagged behind in upgrades until SMC Infrastructure stepped in. Now the current and long-term developments include the construction of an international airport passenger terminal. SMC Infrastructure also extended the existing runway to better serve bigger aircrafts. From 950 meters, it now stretches up to 2,100 meters long, keeping passengers happy and satisfied as they escape into the relaxing beaches and waters of Boracay.
Enjoy the number one pinakamasarap na Pure Foods Tender Juicy ngayong Pasko. Kasama ang sarap ng pamilya.
Welcome back to CNN Philippines. As the Senate opens an investigation into the smuggling of carrots and other vegetables, another agricultural product takes the spotlight, strawberries. In this exclusive report, our senior correspondent Lois Calderon spoke to farmers groups who will face senators Tuesday.
Carrots smuggled from China. Strawberries imported from Korea. These are photos of supposed contraband farm products that farmers from the Cordilleras will present as evidence on Tuesday as senators begin an investigation on alleged smuggling of agricultural goods. Farmers say illegal shipments of produce have been rampant the past few months, prompting the League of Associations at La Trinidad Vegetable Trading Area to gather evidence. The group sent its position paper to the Senate Monday. Its spokesperson, Agot Balanoy, will face lawmakers virtually on Tuesday.
Those evidences that we have gathered, sinend ko na po sa Senate kasi pag nagpapapasok po tayo ng mga imported na mga gulay na hindi dumaan sa pest risk analysis, ibig sabihin po niyan, hindi natin sure kung baka yung mga gulay na yan may dalang mga diseases. We also raised about the economical impact to the farmers.
La Trinidad in Benguet province is popular for strawberries. Farmers there say unfair competition with strawberries from Korea is hurting the 130,000 strong sector. They question how the importer got a license from the Bureau of Plant Industry, the agency in charge of inspecting and quarantining agricultural imports to check for pests. The Agriculture Department and Bureau of Plant Industry have not replied to CNN Philippines' request for interview or comment.
Looking at the permit that was issued to the importer, ang nakalagay doon ay ornamental plants.
In Ifugao, vegetable farmers feel helpless, even powerless to compete with those who trade via the black market.
Inalalaman na lang dahil parang apektado na naman ang presyo kahit alam mo na parang konti lang naman kami nagtanim.
The Senate initially says the Customs Bureau will be at the center of its investigation.
Instead na mag-angkat sa ibang bansa, tulungan yung mga local producers natin na dalhin sa cities at the competitive.
For Cordillera farmers, smuggling could be an intricate web of government agencies and personalities. Getting to the bottom of the smuggling problem inevitably will mean identifying and naming who they are. Lois Calderon, CNN, Philippines.
After nearly 2 years, collegiate varsity teams can finally return to the hard court. The Health Department and the Commission on Higher Education have given the green light to UAAP and NCAA member schools to resume athletic training as early as this week. Teams must hold training under a bubble setup with fully vaccinated players, coaches, and staff. Minimum health standards will be strictly followed, including frequent COVID-19 testing. Basketball teams are among the first groups eyed by schools to join their respective bubbles.
Of course, people are gonna say ang tagal, no? Medyo siguro that the patients was also tested, no? This being a sports event, of course, no? But people tend to forget that aside the UAP, the NCAA, and all these intercollegiate leagues, aside from being a sports activity, is also a school activity. We can never be too safe when we talk about the health the health and safety of each of our student athletes.
This marks a huge step towards the return of collegiate sports competitions, with officials looking to resume play by March 2022. Meanwhile, the Philippine Basketball Association is set to welcome fans again on Wednesday at the Araneta Coliseum. Now, all roads leading to a popular bargain marketplace in Manila for Christmas shopping. Vendors in Divisoria say sales are slowly picking up, but they add these are still far off from pre-pandemic shopping. Toys in Divisoria sell for as low as 20 pesos. Some clothes can be bought at 3 for 100. Personalized gift items also hit this Christmas season, especially for office parties. Customized mugs cost 40 pesos a piece, while tumblers or complete gift sets range from 350 to 450 pesos.
Okay din naman kasi merong mga company, office company na mo-order, tapos maraming sumasabay sa wedding tsaka binyag ngayong buwan. Mas okay ngayon kesa nakaraang buwan.
Okay.
Mas maraming umu-order.
Compared to the large crowds over the weekend, the number of shoppers in Divisoria is manageable today. We have 12 days before Christmas, and that is it for now. Join me again on news.ph at 7 p.m. I'm Pia Ontiveros for Newsnight, where we go above and beyond the headlines. Now, as we end the program, we'll take a closer look at the country's power supply and the ways we can adopt energy efficiency as a way of life. Games don't usually come to mind when talking about electricity, but the Energy Department challenges that notion with its latest initiative. It's set to launch an interactive game to promote efficient energy use. Let's watch this.
Energy sector, yung pamilya ay dapat may energy efficiency know-how. May energy efficiency appliances na in-apply sa pagpili ng appliance. May energy efficiency sa paggamit, sa behavior. At meron ding idadagdag na yung RE, ICT. At yan ang makikita natin sa pamilyang Pilipino sa 2014. Ang Department of Energy po ang parang tatay natin sa enerhiya. Bilang magulang, siya po ang in charge sa pagpaplano patungkol sa energy ng buong bansa. Pagsimula ito sa exploration or paghahanap ng energy sources, kasama yung conventional at saka yung renewable sources natin, patungo sa pagproseso at sa paggamit ng mga industriya, residensya, at mga commercial establishments natin. So the consumer should have the power of choice to utilize energy efficiently.
There was Batas Pambansa 753, which was the original energy efficiency and conservation measure of the Philippines. But unfortunately, BP 73 had an expiration date. Until 2019, Republic Act number 11285 was finally signed into law. When we talk about energy efficiency and conservation, or EEC, it's really a way of life. It's something that each and every Filipino should be practicing. But of course, practice requires guidance, and this is where the EEC Act or RA 11285 comes in. It provides for the set of incentives, whether it's fiscal or non-fiscal, as well as mandatory requirements for all energy end users to achieve our goal of having more energy efficient Philippines. The ones targeted by the EEC Act are what we call designated establishments or energy intensive sectors. This will cover your commercial, industrial, and transport. Any entity that consumes an aggregate annual consumption of 100,000 kilowatt hours both for electricity and petroleum products are covered by this. We'd like to emphasize that the energy audits must be done once every 3 years. The energy audit is important because it allows for the setting of the baseline data wherein the energy efficiency gains are benchmarked against. In terms of promotion, is hopefully you'll be seeing more of our social media placements. Our quad media, our print ads are coming out. In our interactive game, we are very happy that you'll be seeing an interactive game telling them how to practice energy efficiency and conservation in their own little way, and will be available in the iOS and Google Play Store. I'll take that opportunity for the younger ones or even the not so young ones to play those energy efficiency games.
This program is brought to you by
Katungod sa publiko nga masayod sa tinuod nga paghitabo sa palibot, may kalabot na ang pagparagan sa mga buhatan lokal ug nasyonal. Masayod sa gihimo sa mga gitahasan nga magdumala sa rinda sa atong pangagamanan.
Tungod nini nataw kining tulumanon.
Sayri ang lungsod.
Sayri ang lungsod.
Gidalit kaninyo ni Sibiana RPN DXKD Polo.
Sayri ang lungsod.
Dinhi inyo madahog ang paghimay sa mga nag-unang isyu o gisgutan may kalabot na sa katilingban.
Sayri ang lungsod.
Mga problema, reklamo sa komunidad nga gustong ipabot sa mga hintungdang opisina o namunuan.
Sayri ang lungsod.
Inyong madungog din hilamang sa inyong gisaligang RPM BXKD Radio Runda di Polo 1053 sa dial sa inyong mga radio.
Sayri ang lungsod.
Makita usab sa inyong official Facebook page sa RPM BXKD di Polo, YouTube o Twitter. Please subscribe, like, share and follow.
Sayri ang lungsod.
Sayri ang
lungsod.
At ang paminawa ug sundak kanunay matag adlaw Domingo alas 9 ngadto sa alas 11 ang takna sa kabuntagon ang inyo ug atong tulmanon.
Sayri ang lungsod.
Sayri ang lungsod.
Mas binalawak, binalawak, mas binalakas, binalakas. RPM sa iba't ibang mga lalawigan. DZRL Bata, DZBS Baguio, DZKI Iriga, DYKB Bacolo, DYKC Cebu, DXKS Surigao, DXKD Dipolo, DXKO Cagayan de Oro, DXKT Davao, DXKP Pagadian, DXXX Zamboanga, DXDX General Santos.
RPN Radio Philippines Network, DXKD, Dipolo, Radyo, Ronda. Member, kapisanan ng mga broadcaster ng Pilipinas.
Let's admit it. During this pandemic, many of us have gained a few pounds here and there. The next thing you know, you've gained 10 kilos or more. Blame it on the stress caused by this new normal that has dramatically changed the way we live. But while many of us are quick to think to go on a diet to lose weight, it's easier said than done. Plus, not all diets are effective. They're not all that safe either. The goal is to develop and stick to healthy eating habits. But where do we start? I'm Dr. Freddy Gomez. You're watching MedTalk Health Talk on CNN Philippines. While food intake and exercise are key components of weight loss, hormones and metabolism play a major role in all of this. This is why it's important to seek medical advice before going on a diet. Joining us on the program today are Dr. Jan Dipasupil. He's a lifestyle and obesity medicine specialist from the medical city Ortigas. Also with us is Dr. Maricar Escultocan. She's an internal medicine specialist and the nutrition section chief of the Makati Medical Center. I've heard many people saying that they've gained weight since the pandemic started, and it's not just their imagination, it's a real thing. I'll start first with Dr. Jan. Explain natin how this all happened, and let's discuss also how we can now manage, especially with the holidays just around the corner.
First could be the stress, okay? The stress, increasing of the stress hormone is associated with eating of the salty, the sugary, and even the fatty foods. So the body metabolizes these foods more slowly when we are under very high level of stress. In addition to that, it would increase the belly fat or the abdominal fat that puts the people at risk of metabolic diseases. The second one is the reduced physical activity. Because we are sitting more, we are working from home, and then we are moving less. That's why we have lost the muscle mass, and then we have gained fat. The third is the new normal lifestyle. due to the COVID-19 restrictions. We have discovered taking advantage of the food deliveries because it's accessible and convenient. So we are ordering fast foods and even desserts instead of cooking our meals or cooking healthy foods. And then the fourth one, and I believe a lot of us have been doing this one, is the midnight activities. So we binge watching TV series, movies that may potentially snack after the dinner and could lead to inadequate sleep.
Now, Dr. Maricar, let's revisit the overall food choices and eating habits of the average Filipino that may contribute to weight gain.
So during this pandemic, a study was actually conducted by the Food and Nutrition Research Institute, so that was 2020, which showed that they found out that the typical diet of Filipinos, you know, age 19 to 59 years of age, is comprised mostly of rice, fried pork and fish with a little vegetable. So carbohydrates and fat, we know that when eaten in excessive amounts, coupled with the decrease in physical activity that happened to us during this pandemic. So you have decreased energy expenditure. So it's actually a formula for weight gain, a positive energy intake and low energy expenditure. So that's your recipe for weight gain.
For some other people, they've turned to a very popular health and fitness trend to lose weight, and that is intermittent fasting. Dr. John, explain natin sa mga viewers kung ano ba yung intermittent fasting.
It's a dietary pattern. So that is the cycle between the brief periods of fasting with either no food or there is a significant calorie reduction. And that would be the periods of unrestricted eating. So the principle is like after hours without food, okay, the body is exhausting its sugar stores. And this would be the time that would start burning off the fat. And this is somehow referred to the metabolic switching.
A lot of Filipinos really have ingrained in their system that kailangan breakfast, lunch, dinner. That's the norm. It may be merienda pa in between lunch and dinner. So what you're saying that it is okay to have less meals in a day? The body is completely healthy with having less meals?
Yes, you could have less of the meals. Of course, you have to consider the right kinds of foods.
Right.
Eating of the complex carbohydrates instead of the refined carbohydrates. So those are some things that you have to consider when you are going to have a good have a healthy eating.
There are different intermittent fasting methods. Now let's talk about those and explain when does one work better over the other, Dr. Jan?
Okay, there are three intermittent fasting. The first is the alternate day fasting. So there will be alternating between days of no food restriction with days with consisting of one meal that provides about 25% of the daily caloric needs. Mm-hmm. So example, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, this consists of your fasting days, while the Tuesday, Thursday, and then your Saturday will be your alternate days with no food restriction. The second type is the whole day fasting. So it's 1 to 2 days per week of complete fasting or up to the 25% of the daily caloric need. So you could still eat a little bit, but with no restriction on the other days. The most popular type of intermittent fasting is the time-restricted feeding. Okay, so it follows a meal plan each day with a designated time frame for fasting. So we have heard about the 16-8 kind of time-restricting or time-restricted intermittent fasting. That means there's meals are eaten from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. and with fasting during the remaining hours of the day. Usually that would be 16 hours.
I'd like to ask Dr. Maricar, can you have coffee, for example, or some soup broth or water even? What are some of the do's and don'ts pagdating sa intermittent fasting?
Usually you're allowed to have intake of non-calorie containing food items. That includes your coffee and your tea or broth. Okay, so in terms of the do's and don'ts, so we always remind that even if you're doing the intermittent fasting, you need to make sure that you still meet your required protein and micronutrient requirements. Okay, so including fruits, vegetables, and high quality protein during the feast hours. So yun yung reverse kasi niya, the fast and the feast hours. And at the same time, you should also be cautious of the total intake during the feast hours.
When we return, we'll talk more about how intermittent fasting works, what happens to the body when you fast, and how it helps with weight loss, among other things. MedTalk Health Talk is your partner in healthcare. We'll be back after a short break, so stay with us.
Centenary Faith Rewind.
The image of Santo Niño may have come from Michelin, Flanders, now part of Belgium. There are surviving images that resemble the one in Cebu from 16th century Flanders. King Charles I of Spain grew in Flanders and must have obtained and given images of the Santo Niño for the expedition.
KBP marks 500 years of Christianity at this station.
Dapitan City Councilor Jezebel Bing Balisado, konsehal sa Dakbayan sa Dapitan, nga dali duulon og maabebihon sa iyang mga katawhan. Konsehal Bing Balisado maluloyon og matinabangon sa tanang higayon. Konsehal Bing Balisado sa Dakbayan sa Dapitan.
So this is Christmas. What have you done?
Miining panahon sa Pasko, si Atty. Rosalier Matoy Barinaga, uban sa iyang pamilya, nang hinaod sa panaghiusa, kalinaw o panaghinigugmaay, kanimo o sa imong banay karong panahon sa Pasko o sa kanunay. Malipayong Pasko o malambuong 2022 kanatong tanan, pagtimbaya gika ni Atty. Rosalier Matoy Barinaga.
We care for the growing needs of our community. You're watching MedTalk Health Talk here on CNN Philippines. I'm Dr. Freddy Gomez. Intermittent fasting isn't about skipping meals now and again, nor is it about starving yourself. It's also not a solution for weight loss for everyone. That's why seeking advice from a healthcare professional, from a nutritionist, or your weight management specialist is very important. When you don't eat for a while, there are a number of things that happen in your body, including fat burning. Dr. Jan, let's explain that.
For the people who are intermittent fasting, okay, so when they follow that 16-8 hour of fasting or that kind of IF, the people who have fasted for at least 16 hours, they show a fat loss, okay, and there will be a maintenance of the muscle mass. That's why people who could stick with the 16 hours of fasting, if they would be following the time restricted, they could have a weight loss.
Now, there's also the aspect of cell repair for those who are doing intermittent fasting properly. Dr. John, how does that work naman?
There's a term called the autophagy. So it's a process of removing the old cells, repairing the damaged cells, and replacing it with new and healthier ones. So with this cell repair, it will prevent the toxin accumulation in the damaged cell and removing the harmful material and somehow preventing the infected cells from gathering.
Now, I'd like to turn to some of the most common diet mistakes among. First is one food wonders with instant results. Dr. Maricar, dito naman tayo. There are diets out there that call for several things, you know, for eating maybe only cabbage or drinking only vegetable juice. What are your thoughts on this?
Mm-hmm. Actually, Doc Freddy, those diet plans that you have mentioned are called fad diets. Okay, so what are fad diets? They are usually short-term popular diets that promise dramatic weight loss results. Mm-hmm. Okay, so a typical characteristic of fad diets is the over-restriction of certain important macronutrients in the diet that may have detrimental effects in the body. Okay, so some fad diets even require the client to purchase certain products or supplements. So sadly, fad diets take advantage of a person's desire for a quick fix, okay, and use it as a marketing strategy. So as health and proper nutrition advocates, we always remind the public to be discerning and consult a nutrition professional or an expert if they have weight loss concerns.
How about the fat-free, carb-free, sugar-free diet? How about these amount, Dr. Maricar? Let's start with carbs first. Do we really need to snub carbs altogether?
Carbohydrate is an important part of our diet. Okay? So it's an important macronutrient because it is our major source of energy. So we should remember that not all carbohydrates are the same. Okay? So we have your complex carbohydrates, which confers most of the beneficial effects. And you also have the simple carbohydrates, where the simple sugars belong. So usually, for example, in patients with diabetes, we recommend for the limitation of the simple sugar proportion. Okay? So if you are talking about a sugar-free diet, usually this diet is basically about limiting the consumption of carbohydrates in the form of simple sugars, mm-hmm. such as sucrose, which is our usual table sugar, and any other food item that used added sugar in their preparation. So examples of that are candies, cakes, cookies, soft drinks, and other sugar-sweetened beverages.
What's healthy? What should our viewers know when it comes to these alternatives? What's not healthy? At bakit kaya? Kasi a lot of people use coconut sugar, maybe some stevia, or even honey as alternatives to refined table sugar. Ano yung suggestion nyo, Dr. Maricar? Which should our viewers use?
People who are trying to eliminate sugar in their diet turn to the so-called artificial sweeteners or sugar substitutes. Mm-hmm. Now, sometimes they may also be referred to as your non-nutritive sweeteners because they do not provide additional calories or carbohydrates. Okay, so using sugar substitute does not make an unhealthy choice healthy. So you should remember that. So it just makes such a choice less healthy. So in terms of choosing which type, you still need to be familiar with the particular nutrition fact information of the certain sugar substitute that you plan to use. So sometimes kasi they still contain a little calorie. So that should be taken into consideration when you plan your overall diet.
So Dr. Maricar, what's your take on these zero calorie sugar-free sodas? Are they actually healthier? Is it healthier to drink than regular soda?
Does not make it healthier. It just makes it less unhealthy. But the problem with allowing patients to be liberal in terms of their intake of sugar-free carbonated drinks, it tends to displace the sufficient intake of water, which is the best option actually if you want to give your body proper hydration. So that's the downside of it. So yes, in reality, it does not contribute additional calories, but it displaces a more important fluid source, which is our water.
Many experts will emphasize the importance of a colorful diet. Green leafy vegetables, orange and yellow fruits and vegetables that are packed with vitamin C. More of what you should be having on your plate. MedTalk Health Talk is your partner in healthcare. We'll be back after a short break.
Katoliko sa pare. Aduna ba'y kapuslanan ang atong pagampo o pagdibusyon sa mga santos? Unsay kahulugan sa krus o pagpanguros diha sa pagtuong Katoliko? Unsa ang papel ni Santa Maria diha sa plano sa kaluwasan?
Kini mao'y pipila sa mga pangutana o katahap may tungod sa mga doktrina o pagtulunan sa simbahang Katoliko.
Tungod niini ang Confraternity of Christian Doctrine o ang gitawag ng mga katikista sa parokya sa katedral o ba ni Father Leonilo Dagpin Jr. Mihatag ug kahigayunan aron mamugna kining tulumanon Katekismo sa Radyo. Inyong mabati ug sasamang higayon makita sa live streaming dinhi lamang ning istasyon RPNDXAD Lunes ngadto Sabado sa matag alas 7 hangtod alas 8 ang takna sa gabi. Katekismo sa Radyo.
Welcome back to MedTalk Health Talk, where caring is our calling. I'm Dr. Freddy Gomez. Sabi nga nila, you are what you eat, and eating healthy means you stay healthy. We've learned so much about healthy eating from our younger years, and it might be worth reviewing. A colorful diet, apparently, is a nice way to look at it. Dr. Jan, tell us more about this. How can we make this a part of our day-to-day, having that nice, colorful diet?
Eating of their fruits or vegetables of different colors every day. So there's this red, the yellow, the green, even the blue or purple kinds of fruits and vegetables, like the fruits, red fruits and vegetables, such as the tomatoes, the strawberries, the red beans. These are packed with vitamins A, C, and then potassiums. Next is the yellow and the orange fruits and vegetables. Examples would be carrots, the peaches, the squash, also loaded with vitamin C and vitamin A. For the green color, that would be your leafy vegetables, your broccoli, your cauliflower, and this would be heart protective too. And we also have this particular antioxidant, like your glucosinolates, that may lower the risk of certain cancer. While the fourth one, which is the blue or even the purple fruits and vegetables, including these cranberries, the grapes, the raisins, and even the eggplants, may help in boosting our urinary tract health, even the memory, and somehow promote the healthy aging through this specific anthocyanin antioxidant.
Dr. Maricar, what's the real deal on the number of times that we should be eating on any given day?
Weight gain is not necessarily affected by how frequently you eat. It is affected more by how much you eat. Okay, so the total calorie intake for the day will dictate the effect on your energy balance. So as I have mentioned earlier, if you are eating more than what you expend or burn during physical activity, and you have a consistent positive energy balance, that will result to weight gain. Now, in terms of the frequency, actually, it will depend on what is applicable for your condition, because there are patients, for example, they benefit more if their daily intake is distributed throughout the day with snacks. Okay, so for example, patients with diabetes who are on insulin, so they need to have a constant supply of substrates in their body. So it will really be more, if you're concerned about weight gain, the main factor is the total calories, not the frequency of the meals.
What can you say, Dr. Maricar, about those who decide on their weight loss strategy by eating one big meal just for the whole day? Isang malaking meal lang for the entire day, and they feel that they will lose weight with this. What's your take on that?
Almost similar to doing the intermittent fasting, right? So we should be vigilant in terms of looking out for patients who are prone to have eating disorders. No? Kasi usually, those who practice that style of eating, so they are the ones who are prone to have eating disorders. Mm-hmm. So you should do a thorough counseling with them. So you should explain to them the importance of eating a more balanced diet that is distributed throughout the day.
Exercise is another strategy to healthy weight loss. Aside from shedding those unwanted pounds, exercise has other health benefits as well. Dr. John, let's talk about all these good things that happen in the body when we are eating healthy and being active at the same time.
In addition to healthy eating, we definitely need to move, okay? But before we go to the benefits, I think we have to first define what is the difference or differentiate exercise from physical activity. Mm-hmm. Because Filipinos, when they think about exercise, naku, ang hirap niyan. So when you say exercise, it's a subset. So it's a component of the physical activity that is planned, structured, and even repetitive movements to improve or maintain our fitness. But when you say physical activity, it's any bodily movement that's produced by the muscle requiring energy so you could burn calories. Okay, so what are examples of the physical activity? General gardening, okay? Household chores, cleaning your car, okay? Or maybe your collections. Well, you say exercise, this are jogging, this could be your push-ups, planking, and so on. So there are numerous benefits of exercise or physical activity. First, it may help keeping your weight off. Okay, even if you have been doing your right diet, let's say you are going for an OMAD, there would be a time that there would be a weight plateau. So your body would be able to adapt to that kind of eating, and so you won't be able to lose more weight. So you need additional help by moving. Next, it would reduce the risk of heart diseases. It would manage your blood sugar levels. It would lower your cholesterol levels, even the inflammation levels. It may protect our liver and somehow improve our mental health. So there are a lot of benefits of exercise or maybe physical activity.
Thank you, lifestyle medicine specialist Dr. John Dipasupil and clinical nutritionist Dr. Maricar Escultocan. We appreciate your time in joining us on today's episode. Choose well and choose to be healthy. I'm Dr. Freddy Gomez, and thank you for watching MedTalk Health Talk on CNN Philippines.